Once again, we have another beautiful figure sculpted by the owner of Alpine Miniatures. The item number is 35235. And it's 135 scale, and it's the WSS NCO Kharkov. Another absolute cracker of a figure coming from Alpine Miniatures. It comes in 6 parts, which I'll show you here. I'm happy that Alpine Miniatures is putting more figures into the Kharkov set, so if anyone's wanting to do a decent diorama, there's more figures coming their way. Also hoping, as I've seen on a couple of websites, I'd like that too if Alpine Miniatures can start doing some of these guys in a 1/16 scale. A couple of 1/16 scale tanks are coming out at the moment, so it'd be nice to see some figures to go with them. But just look at the detail on this, guys. I mean, I've said it before, but Alpine Miniatures, their casting, when you actually get the figure out of the box, there's just hardly any cleanup to do on it. It's just absolutely beautiful right from the start. And just the sculpting on this and the creases. Obviously, if you've bought Alpine Miniatures figures before, you know exactly what I'm talking about. They're just the top of the range. If you've seen some other reviews, you can get people that do their 3D printing, 3D sculpting. But in the end of the day, if the product that you actually get isn't high quality, or the actual product that you get when you open the box, if the casting blocks aren't done well, or if it's not up to your standard, it doesn't matter if it's 3D printed or 3D sculpted. What matters is what you actually get yourself out of the box when you buy something. And every time with Alpine Miniatures, I've never been disappointed. Just the quality of their casting is just number one, which is why I'll always keep buying his figures. 135 scale. This thing is sculpted to 1/16 scale standard. Just the detail on this is unbelievable. Like in my other video, guys, I've got a blue tack this guy together for you so you can have a good look at him. So let's get started. Here we have the MP40 connected. And as you saw in the parts, the two hands are connected. Given that he's holding the gun in two hands, he still looks like he's in a pretty relaxed pose. And obviously this figure can go with a couple of the other Kharkov figures in Alpine's range that I'll put up on the screen for you. Just put on his pistol pouch here at the back. There we go. And one thing I like about Alpine Miniatures is they always do a little notch where the part's going to go. So it's very simple to know exactly where to put it. And he also does the sculpting around where the part's going to go, so it embeds into the uniform nicely, which is always something that you want in your figures. Let's put a head on this thing. Once again, obviously, if you're looking at this, you can tell this is an absolute ball buster of a figure. But I can't complain when you get two heads in the set. That way you can obviously put them on some other figures. Even paint two at the same time and decide which one you like better. But just look at the stance on this guy. I love the side angle there. Front view looks fantastic. Even this side's nice. Even the back. For some reason I really like this side here. I think it looks pretty cool about that angle there. And also from the front, which is nice because obviously if you're doing a diorama, you're not going to have all the figures facing the same way. So it's nice when you can actually choose a figure that looks good from all angles. It doesn't happen all the time, but this one you'll have no worries with. I've placed a second head on him with the cap, and also looks like a very nicely sculpted piece. Obviously, if you've got a lot of the guys in helmets and stuff like that, it's nice to break one or two up in a diorama with a cap on their head. This one's nice. Another little tip I like to do, if you're not really keen on painting faces or you're still improving on it, sometimes you can just whack a little putty on these necklines, a bit like this, and you can just position the head down a little bit further. So if you're not great at painting eyes or you're not keen on spending a lot of time on painting eyes, you can always just tilt the head down a little bit further. So obviously if you're doing a diorama, you don't have these big bug eyes staring you in the face if you're not that great at painting eyes. Nice little thing to do if your faces are still coming along and you haven't really think you've improved to the standard that you're happy to have all these eyeballs looking at people. I couldn't be happier with this figure. Absolutely love just everything about it. I really like the two heads. And as I said, I'm not a huge fan of the caps. I like the helmets more, but this one here I really do like for some reason. It's got a nice shape to the front of it. Just so you know, guys, there is a stock for the MP40. I'm just not going to attach it in this video because it's very fragile, and I'd rather paint the MP40 and then attach this and then paint that rather than having it connected. They can break easily if you're not careful about it. The only other thing I'd say when I was cutting this apart is just where you're cutting the end of the magazine off, where the pour block is, just be careful with that. Try not to lean the piece on a table on an angle. Best thing I like to do with these sort of fragile parts is almost hang the part off a corner of something and then cut it so you're not putting actual pressure on the part. Have most of the part hanging off in the air somewhere, if you like, and just have this little where you're actually cutting on the table, and that should just reduce your chances of breakages when you're cutting something. All right, guys, that was just a quick look at Alpine Miniatures' new WSS NCO Kharkov 135 scale, and I'm giving this figure a big thumbs up. Guarantee if you pick it up, you will not be disappointed. Let's have a look at the next one.